Hey guys, welcome to my channel O365 Academy. Today I'm going to talk about audience targeting in SharePoint Online. Audience targeting is a feature that gets the right content to the right audience. It personalizes the employee's view of news and information. Organizations use SharePoint to run the big internal portals that support hundreds of thousands of employees and vendors. And then it's important to have the portals to be personalized and relevant. But do not confuse audience targeting with permissions. These two things are entirely different. So let's check how we can achieve it. I'm on my O365 Academy site. I'm logged in with my admin account. You can see on top I have a hero web part with some of my YouTube videos. Under it I have a news web part where I see three news. Then I have a quick link web part. Also, if I check the pages node, I see a link for the page Independence Day. Now let's check the same page with one of my other account. Here I am logged in with Goku, who is a student in my academy, but he has different content on the page. The news is different, and then I see two links in quick links web part. Also, the pages node have two links under it and not just one like my admin account. This is all because I want to target the right content to the right audience. Now let's check how we do this. First of all, targeting your content works on O365 group or AD security group. So we have to have corresponding groups for our audience to target my any content. If I go to my Azure portal and then Active Directory, in the groups, I have created two groups already. One for teachers and other for students. You can create a group from option new group. You will have to fill in some information like group name, group type according to your requirements. When you are done, you will click create in the bottom. Let's check how my groups look like. If I click on teachers, in the members, you will see two accounts. One of them is my admin account and another is demo account. The admin account is the one which I'm logged in with at the moment in this browser. If I go back and check students group, in the members, I have four students. Goku is one of them who is logged in another browser on the right side. So that means the target audience should be added to their respective AD groups. That is all what we need from Azure AD groups. Now let's go back to our SharePoint site, Pages Library, and then Library Settings. Here you will find an option for audience targeting settings. When you will click on it, you will see enable audience targeting checkbox. You have to click it. In my case, I have already enabled it, and then click OK. Once it is done and you will go back to site pages, you will get a column audience in your pages library. This is where you will target your pages or news to your audience. For example, in my case, I have targeted two news to students and two news to teachers. The pages where there is no value for the audience will be visible to everyone in your organization who has read access to this news. The last step is to enable audience targeting in the news web part. For this, we have to go back to our home page, edit the page, edit the news web part, and then in the settings, you will find an option enable audience targeting. You have to switch it on. I have enabled it already. That's why I see different news from my admin account, which is a member of teachers group, and different news for students account. As soon as I disable it, I see all the news. So that's how we target a page or news to specific set of people in organization. Similarly, I can edit my navigation. You can see how I have targeted my navigation notes to different set of audience. You need to enable site navigation audience targeting from the bottom. Once it is enabled, you enter the group name in the box audience to target and click OK. Once you are done, you'll click save. Likewise, for the quick links web part, when you will edit the web part, you will find an option enable audience targeting like you found for news web part. You have to enable it and then select your link and click on this small pencil button to edit your link. You have to enter the group name in this box audience to target. Once it is done, you can close it and save it. And now if I compare my teacher's account with my student's account, under pages node, in with teacher's account I have one link, With students account, I have two links because swimmers is targeted to students group. Likewise, in the news, I see Independence Day celebration in both the accounts because this news is not targeted to specific group. But apart from this news, in teacher's account, I see the teacher's news, and in student's account, I see the student's targeted news. In quick link web part, Power Automate for beginners. This link is not targeted to anyone. That's why it is visible with both the accounts. But SharePoint list column and formatting, this link is targeted to only students. That's why it is visible with students account only. I hope you liked it and it helped you to learn something new today. You can also let me know in comments if you have any doubts. I'll for sure answer it as per my best knowledge. Once again, if you found this video helpful, give it a like, and if you want to keep up with all latest quick tip videos that I'll keep releasing, subscribe to my channel. So we'll meet again in my next video. Until then, take care and goodbye.